Hi guys, I just tried to record this video and it was 20 minutes. That's crazy. I'm not going to make it that long. So instead, things I was going to take about that, things I was going to talk about, I'm going to just like put up here as links, like right here. And so just click those if you are interested in what it says there. Anyway, so let me just like talk about something real here. So this is a empty 8-bit ROM testbed. Well, it's not empty at the moment. Hold up. Okay, now it's empty. And so the idea is there needs to be an easy way to get bits into Minecraft. Like, bits that come out of assemblers and compilers and stuff need to have an easy route, an easy link in the tool chain to spit them into Minecraft. And so I made something called RedROM that does just that. Hopefully it will be useful to people. So, there's some detritus from my original video, which was way too long. I'll try to clear it out and do something and just kind of do this all at once, make it faster. So, what it does is it takes bits from a file, any file. This is just like the ASCII values 0 through 9 and A through F, just as an example. I think that's what that is. Yeah. So, that's this. This is just an empty schematic file. Or an empty ROM file, an empty schematic of ROM that we're going to fill with bits. This is the program. This is what we're going to churn out. So I can just go and it's an old version, so I can just delete it. And we're going to make that file. We're going to make the ROM file with the bits coming out of it. And to do that, we need a config file that I call a layout file that describes this thing. First, let me say that comments look like this in these config files, and you can comment things out and stuff like that. Second thing is that there are some keywords, block on, block off, data on, data off. This is because I don't necessarily know what you guys are using for on and off, for zeros and ones in your own ROM files. If you're using, I'm assuming, the defaults are, if you don't put these keywords, the defaults are a Redstone torch standing up, standing straight up for the one bit, and then a just air, just empty air for the off bit. But if you need like dirt as the off bit or dirt as the on bit or piston or I don't know, whatever you know floats your boat and makes your ROM go, you can put those values. Like I think of torches like 76 or something. You can put those in here, and they will my program will use that as its ones and zeros. If you don't know what any of this means, look them on the wiki. I had to. I didn't even know what the data slot was until I looked it up just a few weeks ago. Anyway, so what we start with is the start keyword. The start keyword will define where the first bit, what gets the first bit of information coming through the program. And so for me, that's over here, and I'm looking down in Redstone Simulator. Luckily, there is a little thing that tells you where your cursor is, what coordinates it's at. And it's at 770024. If you do XYZ, I actually do XZY because that's what the Minecraft level format does. Don't worry about it. It's XZY in my program. Just know that. So 7024. And then 1, because the torch has to be on top of this block, so 1 level up. So, this is where the first bit goes. And then, where does the next bit go? It's 4 over 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 to the left, which means you subtract 4 from the x-axis. And how many are in this little chunk? 16. It's 16 bits to a word. Step keyword. The step keyword tells you the distance between one bit and the next. So that's negative 4. We subtract 4 from this 70 thing each time to get the next bit. Okay, and then times. Times does this. It gives you 16 bits in a word. How many bits are in this little chunk? So now that we've done that, we can put in braces and call, give it a name. This is one word. Bam. And so we do it again. And you can start to see, thanks to the power of recursion and powers of two, how this will define a lot of ROM very quickly. I'm just going to be defining 8, but defining like 256 word ROM would not be too much harder, for instance. So here's one word. Now we use the same keyword. The same keyword is moving this down. One, here's my first word, here's my second word, same. So moving it down one in the Z, do that. Now we do four words, four word ROM, and these are my first two words. My second two words are up here, they're up three in the Y, so we do same, move this up here, same 003. So there's four words. We've done half the ROM, but we're more than halfway done. Eight word ROM. See, all we have to do is one more same keyword, talking about where to put this chunk again. To here's our first half. Where's our second half? Our second half is 10 up. I'm just looking at this little gauge down here to find the numbers. So same 00 negative 10, because we're subtracting 10 from not Y from the Z. There we go. So this defines the whole thing. And if you need more repetition than just doing the same thing one more time, you can, instead of the same keyword here, you could use the step and times keywords, wherever you need to specify, like do this three times instead of just do this one time, or what have you. So there's our layout file. You saw our test load. So Java jar red rom.jar. The testbed schematic, the simple.layout, the test load with the bits in it, the out.schematic, which is what we're calling it. And so we've made a new schematic file. That's someone knocking on my door. I've got to go real fast. Let's see if I can get this thing done. Okay, so yeah, we have our bits in here. Here's 0, here's 1. I can turn this on. Here's 2, here's 3. We have our bits in the ROM, and that's how you do it. One thing more, the RedROM has a optional thing, hack. If you use the hack platform, you'll see that it spits out ASCII 1s and 0s, which is kind of cool, but useless if you're just trying to use the binary value of a file. If you use the dash hack option, then it will use RedROM will take into account that you're using the hack architect, the hack assembler rather, and it'll be smart and use the it'll produce the right file. So I think that's everything. I think I've mentioned everything. If I haven't, then I'll put it at the bottom of something because I've got to go. I'll either re-record this or it'll be short enough, and I won't. So hope this is useful to somebody. Thanks.